If you're like me, I wear my smartwatch to bed so I can get my sleep tracking information and my heart rate info. But there is actually a much better solution, which is this, the Ringconn. This was sent out to me to test out. And it is a smart ring that comes in 9 different sizes. It's made out of titanium. And the battery life is really surprising me because this will go for about 5 to 7 days depending on your use. Now, it's not just sleep tracking, 24/7 heart rate monitoring. We have stress monitoring with it, movement monitoring. So your basic kind of steps, distance and calories, that's all recorded with the application and the ring, and even our blood oxygen saturation levels, which is excellent. So the charging case can charge this ring 22 times over. And the application, which I'll be running through in this video, does not have a subscription fee at all for this ring, which is another positive. The first thing that Ringconn did send out to me was this here, which has the 9 different sizes for our rings here. So that's going to cater to everyone. You can see we go from quite a large size right down to a very small size there, number 6. So the leaflet that is included right here does state that, of course, choose a fit that is comfortable to wear, pretty obvious there, and just test it out at least for 1 day so you can assess that size is going to be good for you, that later on it doesn't feel too tight or it's not too loose. And then our colors here. So we have pure gold, moonlit silver, midnight black that you can choose. And I did find myself here that number 10 worked out the best. I was testing number 11, but I found that was sometimes a little too loose. It's not something you want, because imagine if you went swimming with it, which of course you can because it's got an IP68 water resistance to it, that you don't want it to come off. So that was a good size for me, that it's nice and tight, but not overly tight. And I can easily just remove that. So you have all 9 different sizes there that you can test out with the Ringconn. So this is what is included in the box. We have our manual instructions, a quick guide, type A to type C cable, the charging case for the Ringconn, and then of course the Ringconn. The charge case is of a good, nice compact size. It's a little larger than a standard TWS earbud case that you would find, and it's made out of alloy. So a brushed matte finish to it, apart from the Ringconn logo here at the top of it. And it's a good build quality. At the back of it, you will find the Type-C port. Now it does have a 500 milliamp hour battery within it. And it takes around about approximately 1 to 1.5 hours to fully charge this case. And as I mentioned before, it does give you an additional 22 charges of the ring. The ring's battery life, the Ringconn, will go for 5 to 7 days. Now, typically I am seeing a loss of about 15% battery per day in the over a week now that I've been using it, about 10 days approximately. So I charge every about 6th day with this, but that will vary on how active you are. More active you are, the more it has to record with your steps and everything. It could be slightly less with it. So it sits in there really nicely. There's a little bit of rubber around here and rubber at the top. So when it is in place and the lid is closed, it's not going to be bouncing around inside there at all. There is a status LED at the front. You can see that's gone blue now. And the contact points to charge it are right there. And you see them just in the inside. So it sits in there with a magnet that holds it into place. And there is rubber around the bottom here, a bit of a rubber foot there. What's the ring like to wear then? Well, it's not bad at all. You can see that, yes, it's a little thicker and certainly a lot thicker than a standard wedding band that I do have. But it's light, really light. It's only 4 grams and it's cramming a lot of tech into it. And somehow a battery that will last for 5 to 6 days. So you can see just then there were some lights flashing either side. Now those LEDs are to do with the sensors either side it does have for measuring my heart rate there. So it's got the 24/7 heart rate monitoring, this 24/7 sleep tracking, and of course blood oxygen saturation with it, and even movement tracking. So it can count my steps. It can also count the time that I've been inactive, so sitting down or standing, and then the time I am active, which is quite a bit for such a small little ring here. What I really like about it is the weight of it and wearing it, not a problem. You compare wearing this ring to then a smartwatch, which I normally use for sleep tracking. It's this big, it's bulky, and sometimes when I move it like this, it's very bright, the screen, and accidentally I trigger it, which is the race to wake,
which shouldn't be happening, and that's bright, it'll wake me up, and that's never going to happen with this ring. The only thing you may see with the ring when you're wearing it at night, sleeping with it, is occasionally you see the LEDs, the green light flashing through here, and that's normal there. You can see them coming on now again because it's just those sensors working. Then the application. So it is called Ringconn. It is an iOS and in Google Play Store, which is what I'm running right here, the Android version of the app. So when you load it up first, it will go straight into today. And when you do open it, you'll see at the top it was just syncing then. Now it's popping up and saying network failure. I don't know what that is about. It's something to do with the app. At the moment, it's not the final version. So it's basically like just a beta that I'm testing out here. And that won't be in the final version, I'm told. So you can see information of last night's sleep there. So that was 6,046 minutes. Sleep efficiency, sleep score, sleep heart rate. So 47 beats per minute average. Seems pretty low, but since I've been mountain biking a lot, my average heart rate has dropped down quite a bit. So I'm not alarmed by that there at all. Activity, calories, and activity duration, your stress, and there's also standing time. Well, it's basically standing and sitting time is all going to be shown in here. As you'll see under this menu, we've got our steps. So each of the tabs at the top under the summary, the insights menu here, will give you more detailed information. You can see the activity intensity. This part here, sleep state. So that's obviously when I was sleeping. The proportion of the activity there in an active, low, moderate, and vigorous was only 1%. 2 minutes. I haven't really been that active at the moment. Stress monitoring there. So it gives me a score. I'm not really that stressed out, but at one point did get it up to 83. I guess that's when I was running about this afternoon recording camera comparisons. Probably when that happened. So again, it's breaking that down. You get some information there with sleep stress comparison. And I'll just go into sleep here and I'll show you a little bit more about that. So you can see the different sleep stages there. So it breaks it down, of course, to rapid eye movement, light sleep, deep sleep, the time you're awake, heart rate information again is all there. And you will see this, which is our SpO2. So our blood oxygen saturation levels, which should always be at least over 95%, I believe it is. And it is normally, it's always around about 96, 99%. And the average there, 95, a little low there, but I still think 95 is actually fine. Respiratory rate, naps, no, I didn't have any naps, but you can manually add that in. So that is the insights page. Here we have with the app. Now clicking up here, you've also got a bit more information with the heart rate. So there are some gaps here. And why is that? Well, that's because I took the ring off at times when I was cleaning up things. I didn't want to get it dirty when I was also shooting stuff with this video. So filming a bit of B-roll, whatever. That's why there are those gaps. The steps there have been recorded. And again, we've got SpO2 information. More on the calories. And there's our standing, but this is also sitting. That is recorded here too, and HRV, information on that, and again, respiratory rate. Now, with this, I'll just get out of it, back in Insights, you can see I can go through all the different days here. So I've been using this ring now for quite some time. I've got over a week's worth of information now, and you can see, for example, Friday, I've got more information here too about my sleep, the stats and everything. So you can go backtrack and look at all that information. It's all going to be logged and recorded in this app. Now you've got information about yourself there, battery life of the ring itself too, of course. Now I do lose about 15% every day. Sometimes it's about 20, it really depends on the day, how active I am. But still, I think it's outstanding battery life for such a thin and light ring. Just a few account settings in there, pretty straightforward. Feedback for them. Now, there are firmware updates in this menu here. There's a bit more information on it. So I am on, I think, the second firmware now that I have received. More information about it. Frequently asked questions there. And just get out of that. There is another trends tab here. So you can look at that and see basically a summary of all your information. Now, you'll see I've got a crazy high sleep time here of 15 hours and 17 minutes. That is because the other day I had a bit of a cold. I felt terrible. So I stayed in bed for most of the day. And that is why the sleep stats are just through the roof. I don't normally sleep 15 hours. Although sometimes I feel like I really do need to. The minimum there being 6 hours, average is 10, which is more than I would have expected. But Okay, that's the stats I do have there. So it is a thorough application. It gives you a lot of information. You could even break it down into months, month and the year there too as well. So plenty of info that it does record there. And it's very straightforward and easy to get access to all of that key information you want.
Now, I'm loving this ring here. I think it is well worth it for people that are after the heart rate tracking, blood oxygen saturation levels, the sleep tracking, and you want to see your stress and also count a bit of your activity as well, like steps, movements, time you're active. And this ring, I feel, is definitely for people like that, especially with the sleep tracking versus a watch, which for a lot of people like myself, as I said at the start, that find this a bit uncomfortable. And halfway through the night, I often end up just taking off this watch because it's just too uncomfortable to sleep with, whereas a ring is so easy to sleep with. I mean, this thing only weighs 4 grams, and yet the battery life is up to 7 days. That's pretty amazing, and I don't know how they managed to do that. So the application, it does not have a subscription fee to it as well, which is good because I know competitors with similar products do have a subscription fee, but it's free to continually use, which is great. And then, as I showed you with the application, it's got all that information in there listed there. So stress levels, your average heart rate, you can even set up a warning for people with heart conditions that if your heart rate goes over a certain level, it will let you know, and that's a good option there to have. So all up, I think the Ringconn here, for those that just need those features only, not that of a smartwatch, definitely worth a look. So thank you so much for watching my video here of the Ringconn Smart Ring.